Hello, welcome back to your free training course for Active Directory. All these videos are free and will get you ready for the 7640 exam. In this video, I will look under the hood of Active Directory at the protocols and technology that make it work. Active Directory is essentially a distributed database. The database is stored on domain controllers and changes made on these domain controllers are replicated to other domain controllers. The heart of Active Directory, so to speak, is the database, which is stored in the NTDS.DIT file. The choice of file name may seem a little strange, but originally Active Directory was called NT Directory Services. When Active Directory first made its debut in Windows Server 2000, it was referred to as Active Directory, but the choice of file name for the database still remained. The file itself is a database based on the X500 standard. The X500 standard was first developed back in the late 80s. The standard itself is hierarchical organization of entries, which is distributed across one or more servers. Let me explain better by giving an example of Active Directory. In Active Directory, you have domains. These domains contain users and computers. These users and computers can be organized to form a hierarchy. Imagine the file system on your hard disk contains folders and files. The same applies to Active Directory. Active Directory contains folders called organizational units, and in these organizational units, or OUs, there are users, computers, or other Active Directory objects. The distributed nature of the database allows copies of the same database to be kept at multiple sites at the same time. Active Directory is able to expand further by having child domains. These child domains can share resources with each other and replicate information between each other. This is where the power of Active Directory comes from. Active Directory is able to keep a database in multiple locations, replicate the changes between these locations, and also have multiple domains sharing the same resources. Microsoft has borrowed from the X500 directory service in order to create Active Directory. However, in order to access the database, you need another system. The X500 standard has directory access protocols, but due to some shortcomings in the protocols when they were developed, most noticeably no network support, other protocols were developed, such as the Lightweight Directory Access Protocol, better known as LDAP. So essentially, you have two systems. The first is the Active Directory database based on the X500 standard, which contains all the Active Directory objects. Remember, this is essentially the NTDS.DIT file. The second is LDAP, which allows you to access the database. The two systems may confuse you at first, but to make it easy, always think of Active Directory as a simple database and LDAP as a way of accessing the database. LDAP was first released back in 1993. It provided a simple way to access X500 databases such as Active Directory. LDAP supported IP-based networking and was adopted by Microsoft to access the Active Directory database. Even though other systems do exist and the shortcomings of other protocols such as network support has been addressed, LDAP continues to be used by Microsoft to access the Active Directory database. So, how do you use LDAP to access Active Directory data? Most times, you will use the admin tools provided by Microsoft. In some cases, you may use low-level tools which require you to understand the syntax that LDAP uses. At first, the syntax LDAP uses may look a bit confusing, but it is not too hard to understand once you get the hang of it. To understand LDAP syntax, first consider what syntax you would use to access a file on your hard disk. To access a file on the hard disk, you would first put the drive letter, like C:, and then /. This would give you the root of the hard disk. To access a folder, you would simply add the folder, like users. To access a file, you would add /, followed by the file name, like joe.doc. If you think of LDAP accessing a hierarchy of folders and files, you'll have no problem understanding the syntax it uses. The first terminology that LDAP uses is canonical name, or container name, or CN for short. Think of this as the file name in the example, or object in Active Directory. In this case, if you wanted to access an object in Active Directory called John, you would use CN equals John. As you can imagine, there could be more than one object in the database called John, so we need to tell LDAP where this object is located. This is where LDAP syntax may confuse some people because it is in the reverse order to, say, a file name and path on the hard disk. Let's say the object John is located in an organizational unit called Users. If you are confused, think of Organizational Unit, or OU, as a folder inside Active Directory. To access this OU, add comma OU equals Users. Now, if I were to compare this with accessing a file on the hard disk, I now need to specify where this object is. In the case of files on the hard drive, I added a drive letter. In the case of LDAP, I need to add the domain it is located in. In this case, I will use ITFreeTraining.com. In LDAP syntax, I need to add comma DC equals ITFreeTraining comma DC equals com. This kind of syntax is called the distinguished name. Every object in Active Directory has a distinguished name. The distinguished name identifies the object uniquely inside Active Directory. Just like a file has a full path and file name to identify it on a hard disk and only that file, LDAP has a distinguished name to identify only that object in Active Directory. To go over what we have covered, the heart of Active Directory is the NTDS.DIT file. This file is a database file based on the X500 standard. In order for computers and applications to access the objects in this database, you need a protocol. The protocol that Microsoft uses is LDAP. That's it, the basic technology that makes Active Directory work. Now that the basics of Active Directory are covered, in the next video, I will look at forests and trees. These are terms used in Active Directory to describe enterprise-wide deployment of Active Directory. I hope you've enjoyed this free video in our free Active Directory training series. For more free videos, please see our webpage or YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.